Chorum, Punava, Kochi, Manjal, Pusava, Kunji, Vlayada, Vava. Meow, meow, Punaya, Nisakara, Punaya. Ennai kanda tholuvar, engal veettu Punaya. Tottathil meyadu vallai pasu. துள்ளிக்கிறது கன்று குட்டி அம்மா எங்கு வெள்ளைப்பசு அன்றுடன்
அண்டையில்
பச்சை கிளியே வா 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 பாலம் சோரம் உண்ணவா கொச்சி மஞ்சள்
முதல்ல அவ்வளவு சத்தம்
சரி
பாடி
பச்சை கிளியே வா 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 பாலம் சோறு முன்னவா கொச்சி மஞ்சள் பூசவா கொஞ்சி விளையாட வா 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 மியாவ் மியாவ் பூனையா மீசக்கார பூனையாம் என்னை கண்டால் துள்ளுவா எங்கள் விட்டு பூனையாம் தோட்டத்தில் மேயுது வெள்ளைப்பசு அங்கு துள்ளி குதிக்கிறது கண்டு குட்டி அம்மா எங்கே வெள்ளைப்பசு
De bienvenida, el Caribe venezolano, el borde más sureño del mar de las Antillas, es como un collar de perlas que reúne a gentes, razas, costumbres, las funde y crea nuevas gemas que se lucen, haciéndolas brillar más que sus orígenes continentales. Porque eso es lo que una isla.
It hurts. It hurts deep in my soul to see Venezuela falling to ruins. What I see is a country that feels empty. I see people saying goodbye to the ones who can go away, and I see the ones who stay fighting every day against what we do have, insecurity, inadequate education, and a dictatorship. And today, I only have one consolation, if it can be considered one, that I'm not alone behind this wall. That is how we Venezuelans behave, wholehearted, hardworking, and always echados pa'lante, moving forward. Because God might tighten the wings, but He will never choke us.
Well, I tried to reach my character, and I have to imagine without the money. Tienes que regar los derechos humanos para que no se consigan. Then in a region. In the plains, you realize where the food that you bring to your table comes from, and how much work it takes to pluck it from its origins. And at the same time, it is a region where water traps you half of a year, and thus traps you the other half. forcing wildlife and the tablet metcan to the most audacious and wonderful adaptation. A man who spends hours on the outdoors doesn't even wear shoes because he never touched the ground throughout the day. The fish that built a nest to me.
Each number surprises me. It is not a number. One has changed apart from distance. It is just that now I'm able to see a certain thing outside. Perhaps I used to see uncertainty, but uncertainty was not. Now it is not. I didn't choose to go in.
Venezuela Land of Contrast is an art exhibition that aimed to raise awareness about the current struggles of Venezuelan depicted through photos and personal narratives, while at the same time introducing a foreign audience to the natural and cultural beauty of the country. On the wall inside the room lay 297 names of people who have died due to the violence in the country.
A home without the memories, where waves replace nostalgia and welcome back the thinker with every shift in shingle. Imagine alone on this island with only the stones, their timpani and shoots of thoughts just germinated. Free to die or swim away to grey horizon. Except you're not alone. Near a troop of watching seabirds, resting in the day.
Hello everyone, my name is Yingxue. I'm delighted to be able to talk to you, to share with you my experience of study community education here as a researcher at Tokyo University. First, let me show you a short clip that I took last summer. This clip showed a group of people standing in front of a community facility singing and playing a very traditional Japanese song. The group consists of children, mothers, older adults, primary school teacher, college students, and government staff. Does anyone feel surprised? Well, usually these characters wouldn't be gathering around in the same place at the same time. Like mothers are either busy with their work or doing housework and taking care of their family. Children should be sitting quietly in a classroom. Most male seniors who live alone would rather stay at home to watch TV. And government staff, of course, sitting in the office, dealing with all kinds of documents and endless meeting. How will they gather around together? What are they doing? They are all residents living in the same community. They were rehearsing a stage performance for their local festival, which held every year in summer. And what you just heard is a famous Japanese children's song called Baby Raccoon on the Mountain. The instruments they were playing in their hands are entirely handmade by these little performers themselves, with the help of these grandpa and grandma neighbors as adult volunteers around them. On one Saturday afternoon, these people from different families with different ages gather around here with music playing and full of laughter. It is not just one of the most popular performances at the festival. In the eyes of an education researcher, such a scene is very energetic and beautiful, but also very fresh and unique. When more and more schools and families are competing for better education resources, cultivating children's leadership and their talents nowadays, schools here are working together with local residents to create a flexible educational environment for children. They care not only their academic achievement, but also care more about whether they're happily growing up. It is very important because nowadays, the problem of child poverty is striking in many countries. Even here in Japan, as the world's third largest economy, the poverty rate of single-parent family is worst among developed countries. 1 in 6 children between the ages of 0 and 14 is from a low-income family. One single mother, for example, lives on less than 120,000 yen a month, which is less than 1,200 US dollars, doing part-time jobs and government subsidies. After deducting house rent, gas and telephone bills and various insurance bills, she can only spend less than 20,000 yen a month on food, meaning only 600 yen a day, which is about $6. Low income not only lowers food costs, but also has a big impact on juggling work and raising children. Many single parents are not able to find a permanent job because they cannot work overtime or make business travels. Therefore, they have to choose part-time jobs that usually take lots of physical and mental strain. After a long day of work, they merely have time or energy to play with their kids, talk with them about fun things that happen at school. Some parents who work early on night shift are unable to prepare proper meals for their children. These problems are not just about income. It includes other aspects that cannot be measured in terms of money. Japanese scholar points out that children's poverty has three no's, namely no money, no social connections, and no confidence. At home, if a child is unable to communicate adequately with his or her mother, he will not have enough sense of security and life experience. This will affect his non-cognitive skills such as self-affirmation, coordination, compassion, empathy, and sociability. It will bring him difficulties to make personal connections and live in a society when he grows up. Poverty casts a very heavy shadow on the food and education that are indispensable to children's growth. And the poverty Japan, a society known for its academic credentials and meritocracy, the poverty will be reproduced between generations through school education. In response to this situation, some schools started to provide breakfast. Local government and private agencies offer support such as regular home visits, food deliveries, free tutoring services, and local children's canteens where volunteers provide free food and place to play. However, these supports are very limited. With the finances of governments increasingly strained, the children of low-income families cannot be fully covered with public funds. In other words, while such financial supports are necessary, it is also essential to help children themselves to acquire the ability to get out of poverty. It is called the zest for living, 生きる力.
He is Hiroto.
Hiroto. その変化に合わせて学校での子どもたちの学びも変わっていきます。 全国の学校で子どもたちは何を学ぶのか。
Which is written in the principles behind the course of study in Japan. To achieve this goal, we need to create a more tolerant and flexible education environment where children can enhance their confidence, self-esteem, and ability to love and trust others. And to do that, cooperation among schools, families, and communities is required. So let's go back to the video at the beginning. The performance scene showed in the video is part of an educational practice project called Kids Seminar, which is conducted by the cooperation of local schools, community volunteers, local government, and a university research institution. It is based on the idea of building a small society with multi-generation communication, mutual aid relationship, and active participation of all community members to foster a trusting and a reliable community focused on nurturing and caring for the next generation. It has a series of activities such as science camp, cooking class, and DIY workshops. Take this bamboo instrument workshop as sample. It included more than 30 participants, 2 hours of learning and production, 2 hours of rehearsing, and countless hours of community volunteers on designing and preparation. In this whole process, each community participant plays his or her part. In particular, those older adults played a significant role in passing on experience and light skills on how to saw bamboo and turn it into an actual instrument. After the bamboo instruments are made, all the members then rehearse and perform the music at the festival. After that, those grandmother volunteers working at the community cafe serve those kids a smoothie as a reward. In this project, our focus is not on how many skills children learned. Instead, we care more about whether these children talked to their families about what they made today, whether they smiled or said hello to others, or whether they continued to come to join these activities. These micro-level changes are evidence of whether these children feel trust and love, whether community members begin to communicate with each other and interact more frequently, and whether a neighborhood relationship is being established. Through our participant observation studies, we found out that not only are children shows positive changes, but adults in the community are also becoming more involved. Especially those fathers who will never be seen in participating in any of the community activities before. And busy mothers can finally get some rest by trusting their children to the community. And those older adults who have always been regarded as vulnerable groups in need of help and care are playing a vital role in building the community. Here, an autonomous virtuous circle of small society is taking shape. It could be said that community members have more opportunities to engage in community activities and interactions with children in their daily life experience, so that they then start to feeling an obligation to care about the growth of the next generation and try to make their living space a better place. Today, society has become more isolated than ever, especially in big cities, where traditional neighborhoods is gradually disappearing since the beginning of urbanization. The so-called kizuna, a Japanese word meaning bonding, is becoming weakening than ever. The safety net formed based on an interpersonal relationship in the past no longer exists. At the individual level, the visible communication and interactions, the physical sensing and feelings, the capability to perceive, understand, awareness, concern, care, and empathy are getting weaker and weaker in the virtual surreal world. And if this isolation continues, it will bring a negative influence on the local economic development and its vitality, especially in many population declining regions. Therefore, how to rebuild a relationship in the community is particularly important in the context of Japan, and I believe in many other countries as well. Today, at this very moment, all us mankind around the world are facing unpredictable challenges. So here, we would like to introduce a possible solution, share our practical experience from Japan with our audience, and also we hope we can make contributions to our society from a perspective view of education research. Thank you very much for listening. I hope you enjoyed it.